Okay, so we're back, and we are in, what is this, the Holland Tunnel, babe?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, so we're in the Holland Tunnel, headed to this convention. About to get some interesting little details about the whatever. We'll talk about that later. So, I know we're a little late to the party.
Wrong, you gotta hold it this way.
Oh, God. So, I know we're late to the party, but this Nicki and Cardi, it looks like they were beefing again. I'm not surprised, but I don't know. I'm just getting kind of bored, frustrated with the whole thing, I guess, because I don't know. I don't want to say I'm team Cardi, but I kind of am, but I'm gonna still try to be like as unbiased as possible. I just feel that the whole thing is just kind of crazy, and I feel like Nicki Minaj keeps reigniting it every time. You know, everybody, the consensus I've seen online is that people keep saying, oh, you know, Cardi's doing great. Why is she addressing it? Why is she, you know, why don't she just do her music? Blah, 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 blah. But it's like, it's getting to a point now where, to me personally, I feel like she sat silent on a lot of things. Nicki Minaj is constantly subbing her. Nicki Minaj also has a platform now, a radio show to vent and to just make her look crazy. And I feel like Cardi just got to the point where it's just like, okay, I'm sick of this.
She's fed up.
She's fed up. And just like with the last fight they had, you know, a lot of people were saying she was classless. She was acting like an animal because she was fighting her. But I just feel like I don't advocate violence, but at the same time, I feel like at what point, when somebody is constantly antagonizing you and doing stuff to you behind the scenes, especially when they try to talk tough and act like a tough guy, it's like, okay, they both from the hood or whatever. They both from the street. So Cardi felt like, okay, let's keep it on some street shit. You want to keep talking shit about me, I'm going to pull up on you wherever we're at. And I don't think she was necessarily wrong on that. Could she have did it at a different venue? Maybe. But I guess she felt like she was going to get her wherever she felt like she had to get her. You know, and now it's kind of like, okay, they let stuff die down, but every now and then, still on Queen Radio, Nicki's still taking shots at her. She taking shots at her in subliminals in her records. And some people would say, okay, well, why don't she just do answer back? I just feel like when you have issues with a person and all these things are going on behind the scenes that we're not seeing, I just feel like, personally, I think Cardi got fed up and she was just like, fuck it. I'm going to try to fight this broad and we just going to handle it and just wash our hands of it. So then, you know, they tried to fight. The security intervened and it didn't happen. And then meanwhile, as everything's kind of trying to die down, Nicki Minaj still taking shots. She got other friends, Riley and this other girl, Brooke. They got this podcast called On Site, and they talk about Cardi all the time on that. So she was just getting fed up. And the thing that kind of made it reignite was Hennessy, her sister, got online and was saying that somebody had leaked Cardi's number, and they leaked Riley did it, had leaked Cardi's number or whatever. So the sister was fed up. So then the sister and Riley going back and forth. And then, of course, eventually Nicki decides that she could have kept quiet and not said nothing. But of course, you know,
she got involved.
And I feel like, you know, she's very strategic. It looks like she's taking a lesson from Tekashi, where we all know that she has a new single out. She could have talked about it the whole time. She didn't say anything. She always waits until she has some type of rollout to want to speak her mind and, you know, apparently say what's been on her heart, you know, the whole time or whatever, and take up for herself. But it's all very strategic, and anybody smart could see that she waits until she has these rollouts to build this drama. And then, you know, then she wants to, you know, give a fireside chat about how she feels about everything, you know. And I don't think Cardi was wrong in saying, she was saying fuck the Barbs, basically. I feel like a lot of these stan groups, not just the Barbs, but a lot of these stan groups are out of control. You know, the Beehive, the Barbs. I don't really hear a lot from the Navy or whatever. I like Rihanna too, but you know, like a lot of these groups, and it's not all the fans, it's not the entire base. It's just the trolls, the ones that choose to troll people on social media. That's what it really is. And I feel like a lot of these stan groups, I'm not even gonna call them fan groups, they're out of control and they need to be checked. And sometimes people do need to say fuck you, because these people are crazy. They spend their entire lives online. It's like they don't have jobs. They stay on there all day and they attack people, you know, submitting death threats and, you know, all this stuff to people. And it's not right. And it's like, when it comes time to really support, they don't support. So what kind of fan are you really?
If you don't support you.
That's what I'm saying. Nicki Minaj, I had told, you know, my babe or whatever, she got 90 million followers on Instagram, and she was number 2 in album sales. What does that say?
She should at least sell 9 million copies.
That's what I'm saying. And it's like, why is she not selling? So you rather go online and talk about how much you worship her and you love her, but you won't buy her music. What's the disconnect here? That's why I say you a stan. You're really not a fan of hers. You really live for drama. Because if you really love me and you really support me and I put out a project, I don't need you to go online cussing people out for me or telling them you're going to kill them for me. Go buy my album. Yeah. Support me. You know, it's just annoying. That's why I choose not to talk about this topic, because with the whole Nicki Minaj thing, it's just been one big annoyance, because I feel like she's gotten away from the music and her talent, and she's gotten to the point now where she's just like a hot take all the time. All she does is freaking go on Queen Radio, which I hate that they gave her a platform for this. Like, they should not give everybody a mic. Everybody don't deserve a platform. Cause look what she doing with it. Every time she go on that show, she don't do nothing positive. What positive does she do? Every time I hear about Queen Radio, I hear about, and no, I don't listen to it. I hear clips, but I refuse to report to support something so negative. You know, you really have to think about what people choose to do once they get money and once they get a platform. You know, it's just like, she just goes on there every day and she just creates drama and she talks negatively about people. She's very angry, and I just feel like she's pretty much ruining her legacy at this point, you know. And I feel like she's on the way out and she's just not comfortable with it, you know.
Yeah, she's not ready to leave.
So it's kind of like, because to me, in my mind, I know that this is a male dominated industry, and a lot of times they do pit women against each other like there can only be one. But back in the 90s, even the early 2000s, like, there was multiple rappers out. Like, Little Kim and Foxy, they beefed, but for the most part, it was a lot of different rappers to choose from. And I feel like that's the way it still should be. Like, who does Nicki Minaj support? Who does she cape for? Because every time I see her, the only person she promotes and cares about is herself. Whereas, like, Cardi and some of these other artists, they supporting each other when they have album rollouts and saying, oh, go listen to sis music, it's fire. You know, she never does that. So, to my thing, it's like, she's exacerbating the problem, in my opinion, because I feel like rap, as far as, you know, the female side, it needs to go back to being more unity, you know. Even if the girls, even if you don't, everybody don't have to like everybody. That's just not realistic. Everybody not gonna be walking around holding hands being besties. And it is competitive in a way, because, you know, everybody wants to be the best. Everybody wants to say that they're number one, as you should. But to me, I feel like there's nothing wrong with having, I miss that. Do you? Because
yeah, I miss it, because you used to have like MC Light, Moody Love, Queen Latifah, and a few other females just rapping.
Right. And it feel like
different styles.
Yeah. And it's like, that's good. That's not only good for the culture, but I don't know, it's just good for humanity as a whole. Like, you should be able to coexist in a world and still, like, it's enough money to be made for everybody. Like, I miss it when it used to be all of them. Even you went kind of far back. A lot of the listeners don't know some of those people. But no, but that's cool. But, you know, when Eve was out, who else? Eve, Little Kim, Foxy. Who's some of the other ones? Missy Elliott. Oh, she was amazing. She was such a breath of fresh air when she came out. She was so different. And like even when they made Ladies Night, you remember that song?
Yeah, I remember.
And they had all of them, and they came together. That was so dope. Like, why can't they have that now? You know, it's crazy that it has to be so much infighting, and it can only be one hot female MC. And it's just like, I feel like she got so comfortable being the only one. Now that there's somebody else, it's just like it makes her nervous. Angry and nervous, because it's like in her mind, if she feels like if Cardi's winning, then there's no room for her. Which I feel like it's totally different, because they have two totally different, even though I feel like they're in totally two different lanes. And she's been out longer than Cardi has, so she has a solid fan base. Cardi's getting fans now, but Nicki has a solid fan base. She's been like the number one person for a long time. So I feel like she should welcome it, you know. Just because one person's doing good doesn't mean that you can't still put out your music, you know.
Number two.
Right. You know, she hates that number two, boy. It gets her fired up. But yeah, I just felt like the whole fight was just crazy. Because it was like they was going back and forth on social media. And you know, Cardi was speaking her piece, because you know, she don't have the platform. Like, she don't have her own radio station. So as she should, she was putting loading clips to her Instagram of how she felt about everything, which she's entitled to do, you know. So they going back and forth about what brand support who and what song did who and all this other stuff. And you know, Nicki Minaj was saying that Riley beat up Cardi B and stuff, and which I don't believe, because somebody would have had the footage. And then Nicki was saying she had the footage, but then she didn't have the footage. She was gonna pay $100,000 for the footage. Like, it was just some old nonsense. I just feel like at this point that like they just both need to stay to themselves and keep it pushing. And not just them stay to themselves. I understand that they can't control the fan base, like what the Barbs do or what the Barty gang does. But you can control what your little minions and your side people do, like Riley and all them. Like, if you telling them you're going to keep it positive and you're not going to talk about Cardi no more, then your friends don't need to be talking about her no more either.
Exactly.
And vice versa, because it's just going to make it worse. And I feel like they just need to get back to just both doing their music and leaving it at that. They don't have to be friends. We all know they don't like each other. So it's just like, just leave it at that. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Nicki goes, oh, I know y'all think this is funny, but, you know, I'm done talking about it. We're going to keep it positive. To me, I feel like that was a PR move. I really don't feel like she's going to keep it positive. And I feel like it's going to come up again. I feel like they're going to keep having the same issue. As long as Cardi is doing well and everybody likes her and she's everybody's favorite, like she is, eventually she's going to talk about it again. Probably whenever Nicki drops another song again, you know. Because that's what she likes to do. She's learning from Tekashi 6ix9ine, and she's trolling people. So, yeah, but that's pretty much the topic there. We're going to get back to you in a little bit. Talk to you later.
In 1 mile. You're going to play back.